Hey, it's Jay from Gag Order. You know, this is number 3 interview or whatever. You guys hear my voice all the time on air. I'm here with Graffiti6, well, one of the members from Graffiti6. You want to let people know who you are personally?
I am Jamie Scott from Graffiti6.
He's Jamie Scott from Graffiti6. Obviously, he's not from here. He's from New York with that accent. I just want people to, because I know about you. I learned about you recently, actually. If you could, just a brief summary, just what you want people to know about you, what your music is.
I'm not from New York. I'm from London, and Graffiti6 is a collaboration between myself and Tommy D, who's a producer, and it is a body of work that we wrote and produced together, and here we are in America touring the record, the album. I'm proud of it. It's kind of hopefully uplifting. It made me feel better writing it when I was going through not a great stage in my life, and it definitely cheered me up. And everything I did with Tommy in that year period when we were writing the record on and off, because we were doing other things as well, it was really cool, man. It was really enjoyable and it was good.
Okay. Do you see yourself still working with Tommy in like 3 years or so?
I mean, I don't see why not. I mean, this collaboration has brought me to America. I've wanted to be in America for a long time to play my music, and you know, when something is enjoyable, don't stop it.
That's true. That makes sense. Do you get any comparisons to like other artists, Chromeo, or there's 303? There are other groups out there that have done collabs between each other. Do you get any type of
we get Gnarls Barkley, because I think we have a song, Staring into the Sun, that is kind of a bit more trippy, psychedelic feel. And obviously people found out it was a producer, a writer and a singer come together and made this collaboration. So maybe that's where they got it from. But no, not really. I mean, you know, people can't box us, man.
All right. I know Colors, or I don't know if that's how you say it, but Colors was your first album. What's your favorite track off of that album, like, and why?
Staring into the Sun, probably just because it was the first song we ever wrote together. It was the song that became the benchmark for the album. It was the song that brought us to America. It was the song that was first used in Holland and in a big commercial, so we had a hit out there. So we went to Holland, backwards and forwards, playing lots of venues, really working on the live set. So it was really the song that made this whole thing happen for us.
And I mean, this is just a kind of a different question. In regards to music, how do you feel it's affected your personal life? Are you gaining more friends, or do you feel like you have a different...
I definitely feel like I don't have any friends. So thanks for that question. I was going to go think about that later.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Man, I'm being truthfully honest with you. Like, we don't... We're traveling so much, you know. I haven't had a day off really where I've just done something mundane and trivial for a long time, and my friends really have become the guys in the band, you know. I mean, I have friends that I speak to, and you know, my old friends that I'm still really good close with, but we don't get any time to do anything. And generally you become really close with the guys you're on the road with, you know. That's who you're singing every day.
Well, you don't do anything crazy spontaneous where you're just like, oh, that was kind of fun, I want to do that again?
I'd love to, man. We've been touring for about 4 months, and then before that another year, so it's good though, you know. I can't complain. I'm in America. As I say, I'm in America. America's an amazing place to come to and play your music. It's a very eclectic load of places, and the 50 states feel like 50 countries, you know. And they feel like, you know, when you go and you drive from, you know, 6 hours and you're not even in the next town, you just realize how big this place is. So it's crazy.
I just want to know, what is it that you want to tell people about the future of your music? Like, what do you see, and what do you want people to expect from your music? What do you want them to always look forward to when it comes to you and Graffiti6?
It's a very good question. Good songs. No, I'm being serious, man. It's important because, you know, so many things these days, I'm not naming anything and picking things out, but so many things these days, it's not about songwriting, it's not about lyrics, it's not about melody. It's, I mean, maybe melodies, you know, maybe it is about melody, but it's not about an essence of a song. I grew up on, you know, Joni Mitchell, Carole King, James Taylor, Neil Young, you know, and I just, I love songs. I love things that when you break them down, you play them on a piano, you play them on a, you know, guitar, and there it is. You know, I'm really into bands like Fleet Foxes and Bon Iver and Band of Horses and stuff, you know, where it's just classic songwriting, and I love that. And I'd like people to always hear that as the first thing they hear, hopefully, when they hear Graffiti6. Yo, what's up? I'm Jamie Scott, and you are watching Gag Order.
And with that, yeah, I don't know which interview I'm doing next. Jimmy calls me randomly, so for everybody, check out the website, gagorder.me, and Facebook, Gag Order Radio. Peace.